Hi, I'm Jared. Welcome to Fun Science Demos. Have you ever bitten into a lemon or drank some lemonade? I have a container of lemon juice. Well, it's sour. Why is it sour? Well, that's because that lemon has a lot of acid in it. Scientists can actually measure the amount of acid that different things have in them. This particular instrument measures the amount of acid in the soil. There are lots of different ways that scientists use to measure the amount of acid in things. You don't just need a probe or a meter like this. You could actually use this special piece of paper. This paper looks very simple, but it actually has a special chemical on it that changes color based on how much acid is in something. So if I were to drip vinegar on this, it would change a color. And if I would drip soap on it, it would change a different color. So let's take a look and see this in action. So let's take a closer look at the special paper in action. We're gonna put a drop of vinegar on this slip of paper. We're gonna put a drop of baking soda solution on this strip of paper, and then we might even try lemon juice. Let's see what happens to the color of the paper. So we've zoomed in so you can get a better look. Now let's put a drop of vinegar on our paper. And you can see it turns this pink red right away. Now let's try our baking soda solution. And that turns a yellow color right away. I wonder what the lemon juice would do. Squirt a lemon juice. And you can see the lemon is pink. So if we said that there's acid in the lemon juice, well, do you think there's acid in the vinegar because that's turning a pink color? I think so. Scientists call this pH paper, but we thought it would be a whole lot more fun if we made our own special paper that changes color depending on how much acid is in something. And we're going to use materials you should be able to find at the food store. So to make our own special paper that changes color depending on how much acid is in something, I need some white paper and some blackberries. I picked these fresh this morning, or you could go out and buy them at the food store. You want to put the blackberries into a bag and start squishing them up to release all the juice inside. Now this juice will stain. And in fact, it might stain your hands, but we also want it to stain our paper. So we're gonna rip or cut our paper into little strips. I'm gonna drop three in. And now I wanna cover the paper with the blackberry juice. It might stick to the edge of the bag. You might actually have to go in there with your hands, smush it all in. And once it gets covered, pull the paper out and set it aside to dry. So we're all ready to go with a couple of our strips. We soaked them in blackberry juice and they're all dried and ready to go. You can even see some seeds from the blackberries on our strips, and that's okay. So let's see if these change color depending on how much acid is in something. Let's try the vinegar first. So we've zoomed in so we can take a closer look at the vinegar. And you can see I get a pink color change with my blackberry juice. Now let's try the baking soda solution. You can see it's a darker, in this case it's a dark purple. And let's try some lemon juice. And again, the lemon juice changes to a bright pink. So you can see with my strips, I created something using blackberry juice that tells me how much acid is in something. It's totally natural. So we use blackberries to make our special paper that tells us how much acid is in something. I wonder if other fruits or berries at the food store would do the same thing. Well, why don't you give it a try and let us know what you find out. If you want to learn more about physical or chemical changes or even pH, check out our channel. Science is so cool. Thanks for watching.